Welcome students, I am Archana Machale from YCIS Satara. Today we will study the chapter number 8 from 11th physics. The chapter number 8 is the sound. So let us see about something, the sound. As all we are aware of the different sounds, we in our daily life we came across with the different kinds of sound like this. See, all the musical instrument has their own sound. All the animals, all the birds, all the human being, all each and individual person has its own voice, and by that we recognize the person. So, and even the whistle of the train, these all are the sounds that we came across in the daily life. बऱ्याच वेळेला आपण प्रत्येक व्यक्तीचा आवाज हा वेगळा वेगळा असतो आणि त्यावरून सुद्धा आपण ओळखतो की ही व्यक्ती कोण आहे. तर दीज आर ऑल दी जनरल थिंग्स अबाउट दी साऊंड दॅट वी केम अक्रॉस इन अवर डेली लाईफ. बट वॉट इज द ऍक्च्युअल मिनिंग ऑफ द साऊंड इन द अस्पेक्ट ऑफ द सायन्स ऑर इन द अस्पेक्ट ऑफ फिजिक्स. लेट अस सी how the sound behaves, how is its nature, and how it is produced, how its speed can be measured. All such things can be studied in this chapter. So let us see one by one. See, first of all, what is sound? Like the as we know, heat is the energy, is the form of energy. Also, light is a form of energy. Like that only, the sound is the one kind of energy. Sound is a energy. So it is basically a pattern formed in the vibration or movement of molecules of air. It is the pattern formed in the vibration or movement of molecules of air. See, when a sound is made, air molecules moves in waves, and the waves radiate out 360 degrees from the source until it dissipates. And this phenomena is very much analogous to a drop. When we drop of water in a pool, when we throw a stone in the still water, then we can see the ripples on the surface of the water. See, like this, when we throw a stone in the still water, we can see the ripples on the surface of water. And this, when that means we are throwing the stone in the still water, that means we are creating a disturbance, and what, and then we can see the waves are formed. Actually what is mean by the wave? It is, and how does it form? Whenever there is a disturbance in medium, whichever may be the medium, either it may be the solid medium, liquid medium, or gaseous medium, whenever it gets disturbed, then the wave is formed. Now here we have disturbed the water surface, you know, we have disturbed the liquid, so liquid medium, so the waves are formed here. It is nothing but the disturbance in medium from its equilibrium position, and which travels. Then how much it will travel? It will travel until and unless some force or some external agencies will not stop it. So these are the waves. Now, is it the only the disturbance is traveling? Can we say it is, or we can say the it is the energy which travels, and also we can say the momentum also travels. Whenever there is a disturbance in medium and that disturbance travels, and that is nothing but the wave. As we know, the sound is in the form of wave, so we must know something about the wave, how the wave is created and how does it travels. So whenever there is a disturbance in medium, but from where? from its mean position or from it, from the equilibrium position, and and which is travels, which travels, that is nothing but the wave. So there are, on the basis of the requirement of the medium, the waves can be waves can be divided into two waves that are the mechanical waves and electromagnetic waves. So mechanical waves requires the medium to travel through, or to propagate these waves, they require the medium. Whereas in the electromagnetic waves, or it may be called as the non-mechanical waves, so they can travel in the medium and also without medium. They need not necessarily the medium. They does not require any medium to travel through or to propagate through. Now, these mechanical waves are again divided in two types, that are the longitudinal waves and transverse wave, that we will see later. Now, say here, the longitudinal waves, the example of these waves are sound waves, and the transverse waves, that just we have seen the example, that are the water waves. Now, what is the difference between them? What are the another examples of these, that we will see later. Okay, so let's see the in detail the mechanical waves and non-mechanical waves. See here, the mechanical waves is a wave. This, if there is the material medium is essential for its propagation. We can give many examples of these mechanical waves, that are the water waves, waves along a stretched string, means when we tie a rope or string to the to one end, and with another end in our hand, if we stretch it or if we oscillate it, then the waves are formed there, and that is the also example of the mechanical wave. The seismic wave, that are the on the surface of the earth or surface of the ground, then these are the seismic waves, also the example of mechanical waves. And lastly, the most important is the sound wave, that we are going to study in detail. Okay, these are also the sound waves are the mechanical waves. That means it is clear that to travel sound, or to travel the to propagate the sound waves, the medium is must, or the medium is very essential. Now, the electromagnetic waves, or we can say the non-mechanical waves, unlike the sound waves, the light waves does not require any medium. These are generated due to periodic vibrations in electric and magnetic fields. These waves can propagate through the medium, through the material media. However, material medium is not essential for their propagation. For example, light waves. Now, there is one another type of wave, that is the matter waves. So these there is always a wave associated with any object if it is in motion. Then such kind of wave is known as the matter waves, and this can be studied under the quantum mechanics, that every particle or every object has behaves as a wave. So that we will study in the quantum mechanics. So again, as we have mentioned already, that mechanical waves are divided into the stationary waves and the traveling or progressive wave. Now let us see what is the traveling or progressive waves. As Already we have considered the example of the water waves. Let us consider once again this example, that in this case, when we drop a stone into the water, then we can see that all the waves or all the particles of the molecules or the molecules, water molecules, oscillates up and down in their own position. They do not move from one place to another place. Just they are transferring the energy to another. So here the stone or the source of the ripples or the source of the oscillations, vibrations, is at the same position. It does not travel, but the energy is transferred to the one another. So here the molecules has the oscillations in up and down direction. Here the disturbance created at one place travels at distant points and travels until stopped by some external agency. These waves are formed and they are going to the outward side, and as we have already seen that it radiates around 360 of the source, 360 degrees of the source means in all directions they radiate from the source, and they does not stop until the external agencies stop them. Okay. Now energy and momentum is transferred from one point to another point. Though the source is at the same position, the energy and momentum is transferred one by one, one to the other point. So is it necessary that the displacement, that the position of the particles must be changed whenever there is a disturbance? It is not necessary that only position can change, but there may be change in the form of this disturbance, can be in the form of displacement, maybe in the form of pressure, maybe in the form of density, and maybe in the form of electric and magnetic field. So whenever there is a disturbance in medium, then there is the formation of waves, and these disturbance may be anything, that is displacement, pressure, density, or even in case of non-mechanical waves, there may be the disturbance of electric and magnetic fields. So these waves, again mechanical waves, are divided into again the two subtypes according to their direction of vibration of the particles. So these are the transverse waves and longitudinal waves. Let us see the difference between this transverse wave and longitudinal wave. In the transverse wave, the motion of the particles of the medium is perpendicular to the direction of wave. Suppose this wave is, suppose this wave is traveling in x positive x direction, and these particles are moving up and down. That means these are having the direction which is perpendicular to the direction of motion of the wave in case of transverse wave. So in case of longitudinal wave, the vibration or the motion of particle is parallel with the direction of the in the direction of the wave. in this case, the particle motion and the motion of a wave is in the same direction, or they are parallel to each other. So here the moment is in positive and negative x direction, means in horizontal way they are moving like this. horizontally, and in transverse wave they are moving like up and down. So here the main difference is the transverse wave and longitudinal wave. So the sound is obviously the longitudinal wave, and in the longitude, so we see something more about the longitudinal wave. That is that whenever there is a disturbance in the air medium, then there will be the compression and rarefaction is formed due to the pressure created by us, pressure created by the sound. So from the source, there is the formation of compression. Compression means they come together closer, the air particles come closer, then we can say the compression, and when they go away from each other, then there is the rarefaction. They are behaving showing the elastic property. So the sound wave is the longitudinal wave. See, the motion of particle in transverse wave is like this. See here, the motion of the particle is up and down, and the wave is going in x direction. This is the motion of particle in transverse waves. Now the motion of particle in longitudinal wave, see here, the wave is traveling in x direction, and also the motion of particle is in the same direction. Here in this case, the spring is, see here, the energy is, how the energy is transferred from one end to another end, and the still the position of the spring is not changed. See, only the energy is transferred from one end to another end. This is the longitudinal waves, and the sound waves are the longitudinal types of waves. Now see, what are the up till now we have studied, we have an idea about the nature of the sound waves, and we concluded that the nature of sound waves are like this. It need medium to travel or to propagate, and these are the longitudinal waves. Then they can be reflected. They travel faster in denser medium than in the less dense medium, that we will see in the upcoming lectures about this. The speed of the sound depends on many quantities, and that we are going to see in upcoming lectures very soon. So and the sound waves travel at a speed of 330 meter per second in air at 25 degree centigrade. In the next lecture we will see about the mathematical expression, and also we derive the speed of the sound in the next lecture. Now this lecture I will stop here. Thank you.